So George Floyd's autopsy showed that he had coronavirus. He was asymptomatic. This is by a Joseph Wilkinson. And this just came out not too long ago. And so I believe it was yesterday. So I don't know if anybody was aware of this. Maybe some people were made aware of this by now, because this article has been out for a bit. So George Floyd, he tested positive for coronavirus after he died, according to the Hennepin County autopsy report. And so this I'm looking at, and the first thing that pops into my mind is all the people that were out there around him, the people he was walking around. He didn't even know that he had this. And so that's how easy it is for this thing to spread. And so he might have been giving it to people unknowing. And so they did say there were a lot of asymptomatic people, and they don't even know they have the virus, and they may be just spreading it. And it's not intentional. It's not like they're deliberately trying to get people sick. They don't know that they actually are with the virus themselves. And so that was one of the things that they were saying to a lot of people. And so I know that some people had good intentions, and maybe they were humble and they were trying to, you know, support a movement. But there were a lot of people clustered together. And so in light of all of this, looking at this, I almost am sure that, I hate to say this, that we will have probably some more people that will come down with coronavirus, and the numbers probably more than likely will grow, because there were large groups of people clustered together. And I don't think people really were really thinking about that at the moment, because they were more emotional. And then we had been on lockdown for such a long time, and people were already getting tired of being locked down, shut down. And now we got curfews, so some people feel like they're locked down on lockdown. So, but we might be locked down a little bit longer now that I'm looking at this. And I'm sure some other people have come across this, which makes you really look at this COVID thing a little bit differently, because he did not have the symptoms. He didn't look sick, you know, from the video that they showed of him. He looked like he was, you know, as well as he could be, you know, although he had some underlying issues, but still, you know, he was asymptomatic. And so how many other people are walking around just like George Floyd, asymptomatic, and they don't know that they, you know, in terms of the African American community and the Hispanic community, that they just don't know they have COVID-19. So the report says that Floyd, who is 44, had first tested positive for COVID-19 back April the 3rd, and that traces of the virus can persist for weeks after the onset of the resolution of the clinical disease. So he actually took a test. And I guess he knew he had it. I'm not sure. I don't know. Let's read more into this. So the virus in Floyd, the report says, was asymptomatic but persistent. So that's something new, which means is leading to the positive post-mortem test. So the county autopsy report concluded that Floyd died from the cardiopulmonary arrest while being restrained by law enforcement officers. So lawyers for Floyd's family, however, commissioned an independent expert autopsy that found Floyd died of mechanical asphyxia, meaning that he was suffocated. The independent autopsy also said that Floyd had no underlying medical issues as well. So that's something that we're learning from this right here report. So which the county coroner claimed played a role in Floyd's death. So more than 1,000 people in Minnesota have died from COVID-19. So that's a big number there. According to the data compiled by Johns Hopkins, Floyd was killed by police officers on May the 25th. So he wasn't wearing a mask. So maybe he didn't think he was sick, you know, because what I know is some people think that this is not real. It's a hoax. Maybe they feel because they're not sick, they're not really ill. And if they test positive for something, they're in denial. So maybe they don't think they're sick. You know, there's a lot of people walking around that might be asymptomatic and they may not feel sick, so they don't believe they actually have anything. So I just thought this was interesting. So what do you think about this? Because what I was looking at, there's a lot of people that could be walking around asymptomatic, just like he was, and not wearing a mask, or maybe they could be wearing a mask and it, you know, walking around, and like they say, it's asymptomatic and persistent. So how many of those protesters could have been like this? Just something to think about. How many of those people that were going into the stores, running around, how many of them could have possibly been like this? We don't know. Time will tell, but I'm sure I have a feeling, a strong, gut-wrenching feeling that a lot of more people will come down with COVID-19, and a lot of more people will discover, probably in the coming weeks, that they have somehow come in contact with somebody that might have been just like Floyd was, asymptomatic. You know, maybe they didn't look like they were sick, they didn't have the symptoms that we were reading about previous, about, you know, people who actually show symptoms. Maybe they didn't look sick, didn't feel sick. And, you know, we'll see. Having said that, I'm going to let this video go. So like, comment, subscribe. Thanks for listening. What do you think about this? How many people could be walking around just like this? Maybe even know that they have this, but they're not really feeling like sick, so they don't believe it. You know, they don't believe that they're sick. That is possible. Some people are in denial. They don't think, well, I don't feel sick, then I must not have it. Thanks for listening.